Where were you born, actually?
Okay, I was born in England. Mm-hmm. Mainly because my mum needed to have a cesarean. And at the time, in Bahrain, the hospitals weren't so great. Mm-hmm. And so that's why I was born in England. And then after I was born, we moved back to Bahrain. And yeah, I grew up there until I was 9 years old.
When you reflect on your time in Bahrain, what do you think about that?
I feel like I missed quite a lot. For example, my Bahraini family, none of them spoke to me in Arabic. They all spoke to me in English. Mm-hmm. And my dad spoke to me in English. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and it's only till now I've started to feel like I have something missing, and I've started taking Arabic lessons, and I've been studying the music, and that's been I've been sort of writing Arabic music into my own style as well, and sort of really embracing my heritage, my mixed heritage, and yeah, I've missed that.
It's important to have that, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. It's identity.
Right. What about your music? I've seen you play a few times. I mean, you know, where do your concepts come from? Where do you get your ideas for what you do?
Well, I mean, for the last few years, I have been inspired by Arabic music. But all sorts of music, really. I've been playing with a experimental rock band called These New Puritans, very creative, and they work with electronics, and that's something I've been learning how to use slowly, and I'm bringing that into my music as well.
Right.
But yeah, I think I take a little bit from every type of music I play and all the different people I play with, and just sort of, yeah, integrate that into my way of playing, my way of writing, or just my personality, if you understand what I mean.
Sure, of course. Mm. I mean, we all filters in some ways.
Yeah.
What about the first album that you worked on?
As in my own?
Yeah.
Yeah.
How was it to do that?
How was it? Well, I kind of fell into it. I wasn't planning to make an album. But it just happened that way, and you know, I did it on my own, really, with some help from a few friends. It was a real learning curve, and it took a while to make, over 2 years to make.
That's a while.
Yeah. I mean, it's difficult, you know, when you're doing it on your own and life takes over and gets in the way. But that was a good experience, and I've learnt a lot from it, and my music has developed a lot since then, and I'm working on the second one now.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
When will that come out?
I'm hoping that it will be finished by the end of this year.
Right.
So it's, most of the recording's done, but there's the sort of time-consuming stages of mixing and mastering.
Yeah,
that
sure.
takes a long time.
Who's doing that for you?
The same guys who worked on my first one. Mm-hmm. So Robin Morrison, who did the mastering, and Tom Jenkins, who did the mixing. They're
right.
both amazing and very kind to me, and didn't charge very much at all for my album.
That helps.
Yes. Yeah.
You perform quite a lot live, so
yeah.
How do you find that?
I really enjoy touring. It's good fun. It's exhausting. There was one tour I did where it spanned over a month, and I got no sleep at all. I was sort of very haggard afterwards. It's always good fun, and you know, you build little families, and I really enjoy it.
It's very good. And for the future, what do you think? What do you have in mind?
Well, I have have a new band, which is my quartet and my quintet together, minus a bass player. And I see them as my family, so I've called the band Ahmed Family Hafla. And Hafla is an Arabic word which means a party or a gathering, you know, of like-minded people. And so we have some gigs coming up, and I'm working on focusing on this band. Yeah. We're playing at the London Jazz Festival at the Purcell Room and the Vortex. And obviously my album. And I'm doing some concerts with these New Puritans again, but with an orchestra, which is exciting. And also, I have started a new project with an amazing voice sculptor called Jason Singh. It's very interesting. We had a weekend of just experimenting with my trumpets. Music made out of only the sounds of my trumpet. So not only just playing the trumpet, but we recorded me blowing through the valves, tapping the metal, you know, rattling the instrument. And so what he did, he recorded everything. And then he manipulates the sound and makes tracks and loops, and then I play over with my natural sound. And we used pedals as well and effects, and so we've created something really unique, and so we're developing that. We're playing at St. Luke's, LSO St. Luke's, very soon, Saturday. Okay. Yeah. So we're just trying it out at the moment. Mm-hmm. We want this to become a regular thing.